1927, Lahore, Harichand versus firm Karamchand. 1927 Lahore, followed by 1928 Lahore, Firoz Chand versus Nawab Khan, followed by 1931 Lahore, I'll tell you. One after the other, these three landmark judgments passed by Lahore High Court, 27, 28, and 31, held that the moment an objection against the exhibiting of a document is taken, the court must decide it first and then move ahead with the trial. Because if the document is inadmissible, how would the cross-examine happen? So it has to decide whether this document is admissible into evidence or not. Only then the cross-examination will happen. If it is inadmissible, then you need not to cross-examine. Now this situation continued. 1953 Privy Council's judge, 43. Gopal Das versus Thakurji. 1943 Privy Council, emerging from Calcutta, confirmed these lined up judgments of Lahore High Court that yes, the court must take note of. But they said in this Privy Council's judgment that the objection must be taken at the time of the production of the document by the first party. The second party must be vigilant enough to make an objection. And this confusion continued till 1971, when the Supreme Court took note of the fact, and then came a judgment of Syed Taraji Khemchand versus Yella Marathi Satyam, 1971 Supreme Court. Taraji Khemchand versus Yella Marathi Satyam, where the Supreme Court for the first time said that a kind of confirmation given to all these catena of judgments since 1927, that yes, mere exhibiting of a document does not dispense with the liability to prove that document. Now, Syed Taraji's judgment is a landmark judgment, 1971 Supreme Court. You must read this judgment, a wonderful judgment given by the Supreme Court, where the Supreme Court has held that simply because a document is exhibited, it cannot be considered as proven. And if there is an objection to it, the court must decide that objection. And the facts of the case are very interesting. We must go through that. A Delhi High Court judgment by Justice Lahoti, 1995 Delhi, the case of Sudhir Engineering versus Nitco Roadways Limited. Sudhir Engineering versus Nitco Roadways Limited is a beautiful judgment by Justice Lahoti, although by Delhi High Court. Then he was posted. Later on, he rose to become the Chief Justice of India. Now, Justice Lahoti, in this judgment, this Sudhir Engineering is also a very vital, important judgment for your knowledge. And it holds field because it has been later confirmed by Supreme Court. That judgment, analyzing this situation about exhibiting and proving of a document and what stage the objection should be taken and what stage the courts must decide it, gives a beautiful analysis and says that there are three stages of a production of a document. In the journey of a document in a trial, there are three stages. First stage is when you file a document. Now, we all know filing of a document, if we are filing a civil case, then Order 7, Rule 14, you file your documents annexing with your plaint, your pleadings are complete. Under criminal trial, you file your document along with the complaint. You make a list at the end of the complaint, a list of documents and list of witnesses. That is the first stage, either civil or criminal, when you file a document. Now the question is, once you filed your document along with the criminal complaint or along with the plaint, whether the court will take cognizance of those documents? Because filing of the documents does not become an exhibited document or a produced document, nothing. You've simply filed it. Maybe the court clerk has given some identification. Or maybe your list of document is also given as exhibit. Nowadays it's a practice in courts that the list of documents covering letter which you put along with those documents, sometimes these court clerks give the exhibit number to the list and leave the documents to be given the exhibiting thing by the court. Court will examine and apply a judicial mind to a document. After applying a judicial mind, only the court will put exhibit number to each document. Otherwise, a list is given an exhibit number. So that somewhere some record must be there that you filed these documents. And normally we all file Xerox copy of documents along with the complaint or plaint. Nobody files the original. So according to Sudhir Engineering's versus Nitko Roadways, Delhi High Court's view is that this is the first stage when a document is produced before the court along with the filing. The second stage is when a document is produced as an evidence. When in a criminal trial, a witness enters into a witness box, makes an oral statement or a deposition, which we say, along with that he produces documents that in support of my contention, here is a document. And the court takes it on the record. In a civil proceedings, under Order 18, Rule 4, we file affidavit of examination in chief. Along with the affidavit of examination in chief, a list of documents and the originals are produced. That is a civil deposition. So this is the second stage when a document is produced as an evidence before the court. First is simply filing. And remember, at the time of the filing of plaint or complaint, whatever documents you want to rely upon, please submit that not only along with the list, but also it must find place in your averments of the plaint or complaint. If it is not finding place in the averments, and later on as an evidence when you try to produce it, the other side, if it's a smart lawyer, will stand up and say, I object, it is beyond the brief. It's beyond the pleadings these documents are coming. There's no mention of such documents in the pleadings. So be careful. You must produce all those Xeroxes along with the plaint or complaint, because later on, at the time of evidence, when you want to produce the original, it must be in consistency with your pleadings. and with your plate. So you are shutting a probable objection to be taken by the other side. This third stage, the court says, is that of proving, disproving, and not proving of a document, that is under Section 3 of the Evidence Act. So these three stages are there in the journey of a document. First, filing of a document. Second stage, producing it as an evidence. And third stage is the proving of a document. That further clarifies the situation that mere exhibiting of a document, because the exhibiting happens when you produce it as an evidence in the second stage. While deposing in the criminal trial or while submitting your affidavit of evidence in the civil trial, the second stage, original documents, the moment are submitted, are given exhibit number. But the court says in this Delhi High Court's judgment, Justice Lahoti's judgment, categorically says this is the only second stage. Third stage is when you are supposed to prove the document. So, proving is different than exhibiting. This is 1995 Delhi. Moving ahead, the confusion continued. And then came a judgment of the Supreme Court in the year 2003. R.V.E. Venkat Chalam. R.V.E. Venkat Chalam Daundar. This judgment, 2003 Supreme Court, another wonderful judgment, which I recommend to all of you to go through. It'll settle a lot of confusion which is going on in your mind. A very good judgment. This R.V.E. Venkat Chalam's judgment made a very minute distinction between the kind of objection a lawyer can take to an exhibiting of a document. Now, this distinction is very, very thin distinction, but very vital. And in this Venkat Chalam's judgment, the Supreme Court has held that there are two kinds of objection to a document. First, there can be an objection to admissibility of a document. Whether the document is admissible or not. Once the court has exhibited a document, you can always make an objection stating that this document which is exhibited is not admissible. There is another thin line carved out that there can be an objection where the mode of proving of a document is objected. Admissibility is not objected. The document may be admissible when it is given an exhibit number, but the mode of proving is wrong. You're confused? What is the distinction or meaning of this admissibility and mode of proving? I'll tell you. Kahani aisi hai. Land was owned by three people. Zameen ke malik teen log.